although she's married to your best friend, and you're on top of the world. So answer me this. Can you really say the years of living under my administration have been bad for you?
We are not talking about me. This is pressing issues, not pressing Maurice.
Yes, excuse me, if I may, can we get to the part where we press the issue?
You see, that's what's wrong with this city. Liberals just want to open the floodgates, let anyone in, and make you, the ordinary, hard-working men and women, pay for the pleasure. Well, you have my permission to beat them with sticks. We won't prosecute. You'd be doing us all a favor. Free love, wig out, don't work, make love in the field, and listen to rock and roll or whatever you call it. Meanwhile, Crayshaw, I know your father. He's made a lot of money, which makes him a great person, but for every good conservative, they end up having some wacko commie kid just back from a vacation in the Orient who wants to share. Go take that share in business to Cuba, Canada, or somewhere. I don't have a trust fund or a rich daddy. I know what it is to be poor, to look at the world from the other side. I slept my way to the top.
If you two would stop hooting and carrying on, I have a plan that will save Florida from the yellow-bellied snakes that want to slither into this great state from all places north.
Now, stump-jumping Jethro is using all three of his brain cells to talk.
Enough! We've just started and you have proved yourself, Mr. Shrub, to be just as they said. I grant you, 1980 was not a high point in my career, but I never applied for a sex change. I was merely in an exploratory phase, and besides which, Saul the Wheat-Free Clown was a funny act. Once voted best up-and-coming dietary-restricted comic act in the whole of...
Remember correctly, you didn't win. Mary the Meat-Free Mime won. In fact, under legislation I am proposing, all...